Welcome to This Week in the Future. This week, we have a lot of news from the enterprise. Our first story is from Google Cloud Next, a breakdown of what you need to know. Basically, it's all AI. They've announced new AI-optimized infrastructure. That's new TPUs, more powerful A3 VMs, and latency-reducing network advancements, among a whole host of other things. The takeaway is more compute power for less money by hosting on Google infrastructure. Vertex AI advancements announced include basically a whole bunch of minor improvements across the board, mostly in the realm of generative modeling and chat modeling, PaLM 2 context, which is Google's version of a GPT model, has been increased to 32K tokens. 32K tokens seems to be the golden number for a lot of companies these days. Maybe that this is just the point at which usability and profitability intersect very nicely. They also announced digital watermarking of AI generated images, which I'm going to describe a little bit more in a moment because I think it's interesting. Duet AI advancements. If you're not familiar with Duet AI, Duet is Google's consumer product, which is something that you can use in the Google Drive suite, like documents and chats and meetings and basically all their consumer applications, right? And it is a Duet. It's a helper that will do all kinds of helpful things, like help you generate new stuff. A couple big announcements were Duet AI and Google Meet will be taking notes during video calls, or it can take notes during video calls. I can automatically send meeting summaries, as well as automatically translate captions in 18 different languages, which is cool. Duet AI and Google Chat is also now going to be doing .QA, document summary of chats, stuff like that. Last piece of news I think is interesting. For those who use BigQuery to store their data, BigQuery Studio was announced, which is basically a unified workspace for your data machine learning projects on BigQuery data. So all your data scientists can work together and keep all of your documentation and your work in one place. I think the announcement of digital watermarking is interesting. This is a new model from DeepMind called SynthID, which is a digital watermark that you can apply to an AI generated image specifically from ImageJet. And it is imperceptible to the human eye. And the watermark is detectable even after modifications like adding color filters, changing colors entirely, changing things like saturation, brightness, as well as saving with lossy compression schemas, which is really important. So that's saving as a JPG or JPEG. Does both watermarking and identification. So you can also use a model to scan an image for that digital watermark and have a probability of how likely it is to have been produced by ImageJet. Google's definitely serious about AI, and they have no interest in being third best behind AWS and Azure. They're pushing hard in both the enterprise direction with infrastructure, with Vertex tools that are really made for the enterprise, but also in the consumer with things like Duet. OpenAI just introduced ChatGPT Enterprise, which is an enterprise-grade set of tools and access to GPT models. So that's like unlimited fast GPT-4 access, 32K ChatGPT context unlocked just through the browser, as well as improved security and privacy, SOC 2 compliance. So companies that have been hesitant to adopt ChatGPT OpenAI tools for their own employees and for their own employees' use may be more likely to do so now because of this improved security privacy, as well as the enterprise level features like creating new kinds of templates for your prompts, et cetera. All of the conversations had through ChatGPT Enterprise will not be used for model retraining as well. So this data use is absolutely private. Last piece of news is also from OpenAI regarding a couple of cases against them, very similar lawsuits about their use of copyrighted materials in the training of their models. And these are cases brought by a couple of authors who claim basically the model, the ChatGPT models just regurgitate poor, ugly copies of their material. And things get really technical here. OpenAI has a couple of arguments regarding the copyright law itself. They acknowledge that the books were a tiny part of ChatGPT's massive data set. They do not talk about the acquisition of that data set. The use of copyrighted materials by innovators in transformative ways does not violate copyright. Lol, transformer, by the way. So they're angling that they're not like plagiarists because plagiarists seek to directly profit off distributing copyrighted materials. OpenAI argues that their goal is to teach models to derive the rules underlying human language, do things like help people save time at work, make daily life easier, or just entertain yourself by typing prompts into ChatGPT. OpenAI is implying that the work that they've done in creating the GPT models is for the benefit of everybody. And it is transformative and will help people, which is really their whole messaging. If you go to their website, it's build models that help people. these are also massive profit machines. We have to keep in mind. The other argument is that the content itself, the facts embodied within the message, the building blocks, arguably the elements of author's work useful to ChatGPT's training model, are not protected by copyright law. They also cited a notable copyright case involving Google Books, wherein it was decided that an author may register a copyright in their book, but the statistical information pertaining to word frequencies, syntactic patterns, and thematic markers in those books are beyond the scope of copyright protection. This gets really technical because it comes down to how you are defining what is going on inside the model at the legal level. The outcome of these cases is going to be really significant, right? Because it may determine how companies are allowed to use these enormous data sets that have been relied on for training large language models. For example, if it's decided that you can't do that without compliance of the author, these data sets could basically just get shut down entirely, and the enterprise legal level models could totally fall behind illegally created models, right? Because those data sets are still out there and somebody's going to use them. Humans learn in a similar way, right? Like they read a bunch of stuff, they watch things, they learn, and then they can create stuff. And as long as it deviates enough in content from that original work, then their own new work is considered original and it will also be protected by copyright law. So the question is, like, is what a machine does really any different? So this copyright law is based on the notion of free will. And is it really the case that humans have free will, or is the human brain just an enormous pseudo-random statistical model, like a large language model? So I can tell you that Sam Altman thinks that the human brain is.